All right, hello again. Tonight we're talking about our JIC plugs and caps kit. We had this specifically created and manufactured for us. Listening to customers in the field, reading feedback from other people who make similar sort of products, we've done something that's bigger, better, bigger box, stronger box, a little more reasonable on the quantities of items that we feel are useful and items we feel aren't as useful. We've reduced the quantities. We've also added O-rings, which gives the JIC plugs and caps kit just a bit better versatility. If you look at our kit, it's in quite a large box. Plenty of room for extra bits and pieces. Starting at the first compartment, 7/16 JIC male and females, 1/2 inch JIC males and females, 9/16 JIC males and females, 3/4 JIC males and females, 7/8 JIC males and females, 1/16 JIC males and females, and 1/5 JIC males and females. Also, little packets of O-rings, which when you add them to your male, to the shoulder of the male plug, you actually create what's called a port plug, but a low pressure port plug. And I'll explain that a little later. So, what will these sizes and plugs actually do? Generally, it's good for identifying the thread that you have actually on your hose fitting, or the threads that you might have in your valves and adapters, what you have in your cylinders, and what you even have, what kind of threads you have in. For example, this is a flow divider. So if you have a known plug and known cap with a known thread, you can then identify what kind of hoses you have, what kind of adapters you have, and get them made or order the parts you need to make them yourselves. So this kit is good for hydraulic hose sizes or hydraulic fittings, you know, ranging from 1/4 inch inside diameter to 3/8. To 1/2 inch, to 5/8, to 3/4 ID, all the way up to 1 inch ID. So this is 1/5/16. It's a, you know, a big range of sizes that this kit will actually do. So plenty of versatility in this kit. Now, how do we use them? First thing, for example, disconnect, if you're working on an excavator or a piece of machinery that has blown a hose or has some sort of hydraulic leak, and you've undone a hose, the first thing that you need to do is protect the valve from contamination if you're going to move away and do other things, and also plug the hose. So, for example, this looks like JIC, I'm pretty sure it is. If I grab the JIC plug and cap, so straight away I've protected the hose and stopped oil leaking out of the hose. If this valve was an open center, in other words, in the middle position, it's open to the pressure port and also the tank port. If the tank is higher, this will start oozing oil. Yeah, so by putting a cap, you basically prevent oil from leaking out everywhere and losing basically a tank of oil. We've just proven that this adapter is a 9/16 JIC because this 9/16 JIC cap went on, and we've proven that the hose we've just removed is a 9/16 JIC female because a 9/16 male JIC cap plug fits into it. So, there are two main advantages. Again, this is the tank return line. As soon as you remove a tank return line, on most equipment, if this is going, this hose is going back to tank, it's going to ooze oil quite quickly. And again, I know my sizes, so I know what this is. So the first thing to do is grab a 3/4 JIC plug and stop oil oozing out from the tank. If you're going to remove this valve because you need to do work, you'll disconnect all your hoses, you put plugs on all your hoses, and you put caps on all the adapters. Yeah? This is one way of protecting not only the hoses from contamination, but also protecting the valve from first leaking oil out into your pickup truck or your ute or into the boot of your car, and at the same time also protecting the valve from foreign contamination, whether that's water, snow, or dirt, or dust. Yeah? You could be taking this valve off and putting it into storage, you know, for the winter months or whatever. Yeah? So this is just one way of protecting what's inside the valves. Another useful item for the plugs and caps is when you've disconnected a hose from a cylinder. Yeah. Again, for this example, this looks like 9/16 JIC. Is this a 9/16 JIC port? Let's grab a 9/16 cap. Feels like it. So what have we just done? We've protected the cylinder from contamination. And if you'd remove the hose from here, this male plug would go into the hose to, again, protect the hose from contamination and to protect and prevent oil leaking. If, for whatever reason, you had broken this adapter, you'd remove the broken piece, and you need to plug this port to protect the internals of the cylinder again from contamination or to prevent oil from leaking out. One of the things you can do, grab your O-ring, I should have got an O-ring pick, so you now have an O-ring on that shoulder. Once it goes into the port, you've basically protected your cylinder from contamination, and you've also created what's called a low pressure port plug. This won't take high pressure because the shoulder is not that big, but for preventing oil leaking out and preventing contamination going in, they're ideal. So these items are available from our web store, HYDRAULIC.ONLINE, also available from eBay Australia, and also available from Amazon AU and Amazon US. Get yourself a set. There's 92 pieces in here. There's plenty of room in the compartment, in the case, for extra bits and pieces. Great value for money, and will save you lots of stress and keep your equipment and hoses clean. That's it. Oh, more. There's more.